about the 8th graders. They've had quite the busy year so far. In 8th grade, we start off our year with a joint marching band performance with the high school band. They marched in early October, and we played a disco 70s show, spelled out Byron and spelled out disco, and it was really, really neat. You might have seen that picture floating around on Facebook or on the school website. It was really very cool. These guys did a great job. I'm always impressed with how well they take to marching band and how much fun they have doing it, and how excited they are to finally play fun music. So those guys started off the year with that. They've played at 2 spirit assemblies so far this year. We have a spirit assembly to end each middle school sports season. They played some songs at those, and they played a patriotic piece at this year's Veterans Day. Thank you, program. Ceremony, that's the word I was looking for. This year's Veterans Day ceremony, they played a medley of American Revolution songs, and they did a really great job. So we've been, here's this music, and we finally settled on some Christmas music around Halloween time, which they always love. And like I was talking about with 7th grade, we had several 8th graders audition for the ILMEA District 8 bands. We had 4 7th graders, or 8th graders, I'm sorry, chosen for those bands. One was chosen for the District 8 Jazz Band, which is a very difficult band to make it into. It's very small instrumentation, one on a part, a very elite group, and that person was Alexis Trank. And then we had 3 of our 8th grade flute players make it into the District 8 concert band, and that is Maddie Libman, Maggie Hunter, and Kaylee Bell. And if that wasn't enough, Maddie Libman was also chosen for the District 2 Orchestra because she plays cello on the side. Why wouldn't you? So she prepared 2 audition sets of music and made it into both and sat second chair in the orchestra, which is just incredible, Maddie Libman. So we're gonna get started with a little bit different kind of piece, a little programmatic music here, telling a story for you, and we're gonna start with Ashton introducing it.
"'Twas the Night Before Christmas' is a poem first published anonymously in 1823 and later attributed to Clement Clark Moore, who acknowledged authorship in 1837. The poem, which has been called arguably the best known verses ever written by an American, is largely responsible for some of the conceptions of Santa Claus from the mid-19th century to today, and has had a massive impact on the history of Christmas gift giving. Prior to the poem, American ideas about St. Nicholas and other Christmastime visitors varied considerably. Narrated by 8th grader Olivia Bradford, we open our portion of the concert with 'Twas the Night Before Christmas,' arranged by Jack Bullock."
Thank you.
his chin was as white as snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. Aside of his nose, giving a nod, up the chimney he rose.